All right, what's up, fiends? Dan Mendoza, what's going down? Let's do a Hell Witch. What do you say, man? My drawing glove, because I don't like to touch paper. All right, let's see. This is also the first drawing of the day. So, got my morning coffee. On my Sad Girl Psycho Baby coaster. Listening to some Ill Repute punk rock music. It's a good way to start off your morning. A lot of times when I'm drawing, I don't really even know what I'm going to draw. Unless it's like for interior pages and I'm doing a story and stuff. But when I'm just doing this stuff, I just kind of turn off my brain. So for Hell Witch, I don't, you know, I see how everybody does it, you know, and I draw so much different than all you guys. So it's like, I kind of just do it my way now, and I give her this jagged scalp line and stuff, and I think it looks cool. So I usually stick her horns right in between that. You see my style is like really cartoony and stuff. It's just I just love animation, like just growing up on cartoons and like Thunder the Barbarian and Silverhawks and Voltron and stuff like that. It's just then you know, Disney movies and stuff. It just I kind of was more influenced by that stuff than American comic books, you know, like everybody's has been influenced at one point or another by American comics. And, you know, me too. And, you know, I was learning lots of anatomy and stuff, like off of artists like, you know, Jim Lee, Bart Sears, and all that stuff. But, then I always go back to cartoons. Always go back to animation. kind of tilt things up. I know this is for a video, but I kind of tilt it up when I roughen the body, because if I draw this way, it's the book's now at an angle from where my head is, so it could distort the anatomy. So I kind of have to tip it up a little bit. So I'll just rough that in real quick. So when I draw, I don't do all the cylinders and stuff. It makes everything stiff. I learned this off of Marvel Comics, the How to Draw Comics the Marvel Way, and there's a breakdown showing that you can do drawings. You can do the cylinder shapes, or you can kind of just scribble it in, and that's what I like to do. I like to scribble it in. Of course, I'm thinking about the shapes, but I just I like to rough it in really loose like that. It just seems to give it more flow. So this is what I got so far. I'm gonna change this hand a little bit. That's pretty much roughed in. So that's basically my roughs. So now I just go and do some tighter pencils. We'll figure out what she's gonna be wearing. And we're good to go. Get another sip of that coffee. Always lay in, even if it's not going to be a nude. I kind of lay in where the nipples go and stuff like that. It just helps you lay in the clothing. I'll do this tight little kind of series of buckles, I think would be cool. So looking cool. Let's get this hand in there. Get these wings in there. I think I'm gonna redo these eyebrows. Let's see. So I'm laying these eyelashes first. Get these eyebrows in here. Make it a little bit more sinister. Bring it, I curve it this way and then I go that way. It's just, it's an old, an old Marvel Comics, you know, like, like all the old artists would do it and stuff. Like John Buscema and stuff. All right, let's ink it. Thank you. Got that done. Let's get the larger sizes over here of ink pens. I usually ink everything with a point, an 05, a 5mm, and then for like small stuff, it's a 3, but it's a 5. I've been switching back and forth from Copic liners to Microns. I've always used Microns, and then I went to all Copic, but now I'm slowly going back to Microns. I think it just makes cleaner lines. Can't forget that Hellwitch piercing right here. Almost forgot. Bam. All right, so that's all the line work. I gotta fill in some blacks and stuff here, but that's pretty much it on the line work. So we'll do some Sharpie action. Just filling all these blacks. It's another reason I like working digital. I could just click all this shit and make it black. It's like bam, 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 black, done. You just sit here and fucking color it in. I don't crosshatch. I'm not a big crosshatch guy. Crosshatch is just stuff. It's just stuff that was made back in the day, man. Just to show depth or, dimension and stuff. And it's just. That's back when they used to just color with flat colors. And it's like now it's like we use multicolors and make tones and stuff. And it's like it's. All that dimension is can be done with good coloring, man. I don't see the need to do any kind of crosshatching really. With my stuff being so cartoony, like you don't see no crosshatching in cartoons, so. So you don't see it in my drawings either. So bear with me, this is, I gotta do all these blacks too, that's just the boring part. It's like most of the work goes in to, like my favorite part is always roughing it out and penciling, because that's just like the fun part, the building part, and then the inking part is like the worst. I hate inking shit. It's just the tediousness of it, of basically redrawing what you already fucking drew. But then once that's all done, when we get into the coloring, I like the coloring part. So I like the beginning part and the end part, not the middle part. Okay, I did it. It's all black. So I always put, since I don't cross hatch, I always put, dark tones in the areas that create the most shadows. So under the chin, so on the neck, and then under the boobs, right there on her rib cage. So. All right, cool. So now I got to erase some of these pencils, and I'm always scared that when I do it, it's gonna smear the fucking ink. So, let's hope for the best. I did it. Nothing bad happened. Give it the old sweeperoo. Okay. All right, time to start coloring. I think of what colors to use. I think a brick beige, toast, light caramel, dull ivory. We'll just go with a. We'll do a test run on. How about this brick beige? Let's see how that looks. Looks pretty good. Okay, we'll start with this brick beige. When I'm coloring, I'm just on default, I always put the light source coming this way. It's just automatically my brain just has me do it. Just like when I draw, even a straight on view, I always draw the head slightly turning that way. It's just my default thing my brain does. Okay, that's brick beige, so I'm gonna try toast, but I think toast might be the exact same color. If that's true, I'll go to maybe a raw silk or a dull ivory. Oh no, it's different. All right, cool. All my shading is the nice flat tones of just like in cartoons and anime, that cell shader style. So now I just do the darker tones. I think dull ivory, I think. Not that dark. Let's see, what can I do? I don't want to really use this light caramel. It's just going to turn like a dark brown. But we'll see how that looks though. It's not bad, I guess. So I did a little bit of that light caramel, then I'm gonna go over the same thing with the dull ivory. All right, so now I'm gonna cut all that in. Throw in some pinks, because I just put fucking pink on everything. All my pinks are fucking drying out. Next is all the, let's do all the grays. I use cool grays, so this is a C4. Lay in her horns. That's laid in. I'm gonna put some red on it. with some an odd thing, but I'm gonna put blueberry for her wings. Fuck it. Almost about done. Let's get those red eyes in there. Dirty up this talon thing she's got. Alright, so we gotta do the buckles. We'll do them. We'll do with the blue. So I'll throw in some stuff. I think she's about done. Let's put some stuff in the background and then do highlights, and that's it. Let's see. Just some oranges. That is drying out on me. I gotta order another one. Put that to the side. Let's get some highlights on here, and that's about it. For the highlights, I use these jelly roll pens. Bill McKay gave me my first jelly roll pen. He was like, this is how I do my highlights. And I was like, oh, that's cool. Because before that, I was like, well, maybe I use white out pens and stuff like that. And you couldn't get those thin lines that you wanted. I think that's about done. I gotta put a couple of definition lines on her face, and that's it. Guys, let's see. Put my name on her. And we are done. So, that is a Hell Witch sketch. I hope you enjoyed it.